Hi, my name is Molly Powell.
And I'm Mariana Ortiz.
And we're presenting our translational potential pitch for SenseNC's BPA biosensor.
The U.S. has one of the largest medical device markets in the world, valued at $160.8 billion and making up about 40% of the global medical device market. It is driven by innovation, as healthcare providers are always looking for the next piece of technology that will help them treat their patients more effectively. BACE would be such a device as it would provide a fast and accurate way for doctors to monitor their patients' BPA levels. The therapeutic drug monitoring market favors epileptic drugs due to their complicated pharmacokinetics and varying therapeutic ranges. Monitoring BPA levels is important to healthcare personnel because of the drug's high binding percentage to the protein albumin in the blood. 90 to 95% of BPA becomes bound. High binding tendency reduces the effectiveness of the drug and can even cause BPA toxicity due to serum albumin concentration shifts. This makes determining the best therapeutic range for a patient difficult, and BACE will help reduce the risk of BPA toxicity and make prescribing BPA easier for doctors and safer for patients. There are over 5 million patients taking BPA today, and our device will help them receive more effective and efficient testing by doctors.
The key resources of this project were NC State's lab spaces and materials, as well as guidance from local medical professionals. We received information and opinions about the use of BPA in the treatment of epilepsy from a doctor in the Raleigh area to better understand the effect our research and the productiveness of our sensor could have in our community. Online journal articles also proved to be a key resource as they helped us develop the chemistry behind the sensor by providing valuable information about therapeutic drug monitoring, sensing fatty acids, and enzyme kinetics. Micronet was our key partner during the development of BACE. For the electrical team, they provided guidance on what to research in regards to controllers.
Research and development is an important action that we had to perform to create the device, and it will also be important in the future. Continuous investments in R&D will lead to improvements in the device that will help us keep our advantage in the market. We want to ensure that we continue to have the most efficient double enzyme reaction sensor possible. In regards to marketing, we must get FDA approval. As a Class 2 device, we expect FDA approval to take about 6 months. Once approved, we will need to advertise to raise awareness of BACE and the potential it has to make the therapeutic drug monitoring of BPA more effective. In addition, we will also prioritize building connections to develop and maintain relationships with healthcare providers who may be interested in purchasing the device. We want to continuously have their feedback about our device so we can make improvements that suit their needs. Finally, selling and distributing is important as it will be the main way in which we make profit and get the device to healthcare providers. Overall, we would expect the release of the device into the market following device completion and approval to occur in 2024.
Setting a reasonable price for our device is essential for ensuring we make a profit on it. Costs related to research, FDA market fees, materials and supplies, employee pay, and marketing will be faced in the process of getting our product to the market and maintaining its quality. We expect to pay $5,236 per year for the FDA medical device fee, and with engineers working at an average of $30 an hour, we would pay $60 for labor per device if the production was at a rate of 100 devices per week. Hopefully, as speed and efficiency of production increase, some of these costs will decrease. Based on the cost table we developed, we expect each sensor to cost us $648 to make. We will price the device at $875, leaving a profit margin of $228 per sensor. This is just above a 25% profit margin. Thank you!